All right, so welcome. Welcome back for Solus Project Chapter 2. They've been calling it Part 1 and such. I think I'm just calling it Chapter because I think that's easier to differentiate with my Let's Play parts, because I tend to call things Part in that as well. It's just my own personal naming nomenclature, but whatevers. And thank you, Perplex, Sir Perplex, for the 4 months in a row. So, as you might have seen, I said I was in sort of a different spot here. I think this was just the last save shrine that I went to and forgot. So I assume down this hill will be that creepy green trap. The hallways of darkness. Yep, alright, that is what it is. Creepy green trap. Sneaky and mean. Whoa, buddy. And right around the corner is the next forward vector, which is the one that I actually was interested in going to. There we go. Let's see, we want the translocator. I had hotkeys before, and now I don't remember what they are anymore. It's freaking, what, like 5 days since I played this and I already forgot? Right, so if you remember up there, we've got a strange fellow, a little enigmatic, who seems to be holding a scepter or a staff of some kind. You want me to continue to follow the cable? I can do this. I can do that, and this, and that. But first, I'm gonna make it a little brighter in here. I forgot how immobile I was. Just sort of chunky when I walk around. I'm like, hey, I want to walk a little quicker, and I just maintain my momentum. So there seems to be a bunch of entrances here. Oh, it's those med packs that you've got to put alien food inside of. What are those leaves? Some kind of ferns, I guess. Individually modeled slats. I'm always a big fan of those. And not sprites, either. Excellent. Good work. Good work, lads. We're going... Let's check this room now. Yeah, I feel like so much heavier than I thought I was before. It's funny, you get really used to the way you feel when you move around in a game. And that doesn't always mesh very well with the way that... I forgot I did that. It doesn't always mesh really well with the other first-person games you may have played, like, this week, and all of a sudden you start to notice little things that didn't stand out prior. So today's thing that I'm noticing is, yeah, bouncing into walls a lot. I'll work on it. Okay, a lot of dramatic music happening here. Oh, we got one of those wild skull people. I'm wondering if the big... gestalt is going to be that I'm not the first human to find this place, and maybe, like, panspermia brought us here ages ago. Because that's an ankh. Do I want that? I don't think so. I don't think I need any fluff right now. What do you want? Wait, what was that? Was that an alien pie? No, it's a shield. A heavy shield? I guess there's combat then, huh? Why would I want a shield? Oh, maybe it goes in a door or something. Let's teleport through here. Unless I can bash it. I'd rather bash it if I could. Add a little element of dynamism here? No, no bashing's allowed. I'm definitely appreciating the long-form sense of content to this. The fact that there's a little bit to keep coming back to. And the fact that they're going to go ahead and make those delineations for me, because I can't be trusted to make them myself. And no, that I didn't mean that in a derogatory way at all. I mean, honestly, I would probably sit and play this for like 100 hours if this was all together. So right now, I think I'm getting the ideal experience because I know when I can stop. Yeah, calories are okay, water's not great, I should probably keep moving. Kind of forgetting about the survival elements a little bit, which is not useful for me. I want to actually just keep moving. Shoot a disc up here, maybe? Didn't quite. That'll do it. Alright. What about up here? What do we have? Oh, dark, dark room. Mysterious structures abound. I'm a fan of this. I like the fact that we can do some exploration in sort of a non-traditional way. Oh, posing skeletons always the saddest thing ever. Instead of just walking around some open plain, looking at everything, sort of like going down the checklist, sometimes you get to teleport yourself into weird positions. Jeez. It's like something killed everyone all at the same exact moment is the only thing I can believe. Can I shoot a thing through there somehow? I'm nearly certain that that's a no. Wedge it up there and see what does that do. Nothing. What about... hit it with the hammer again? This is not a hammer stone? No, I didn't think so. Is it a push stone? No, no push stone. There's just too many of them standing and sitting in positions that look like casual, just like nobody's preparing themselves to die when they're just sitting in front of a door frame with their arm around somebody. That's usually not how people go out. And there's no sign of trauma to them either. Oh, thank goodness for this water. That was gonna be a problem for me, actually. Some of that sweet saline back in my veins. Alright, now we're all okay. Might need some sleep at some point, but, you know. Just drink a Red Bull, I guess. Should we pursue? Well, we will have to eventually. A line of mushrooms down there. This looked like a button for a second. Something I'm meant to stand on. Oh. I can definitely take a peek in there. No doubt in my mind I can translocate through that. Do I want to, though, is the real question. Yeah, I do. Look at the genie's magic lamp. Resistance to heat stroke plus one. The relic of day. Whoa! Oh. We hammering, boys. Hammering works really strangely in this game. You have to target key points that the wall deems are acceptable for hammering. I understand why it works this way. It's just like, hammering is a series of procedures to be completed one at a time. It's rather unintuitive, though, that it keeps changing position from, like, up and down, left and right. That part is probably not ideal. It would be fine if you just let the person just click anywhere on any of those bricks and it counts as hammering. But I guess for that reason it might have been discouraged, because maybe you could hammer something by accident and then find it. I don't know if the discovery element of this is supposed to be difficult or not. I'm going very slowly through these rooms, I understand this. I'm pretty sure that if I just miss one of them, though, I'm gonna miss some critical bit of information. More water. How ancient is this trough of water? Also, should I really be drinking out of it, considering these appear to be toilets? I mean, I honestly don't know what they are, but they give the toilet-ish appearance. Although, imagine this room all full of people using them at the same time. This would be a bit of a mess. Now let's go upstairs. We're nearing the top. We've just got a couple more rooms here, it looks like. My character seems to be a little bit flipping out because... What is the problem here? Oh, I must have held down sprint for a long time by accident. I didn't even mean to. I just heard him breathing really heavily. I was like, what's the problem? Are you too hot? Holding the torch too close to your head or something? Freaking, just hold it further away from your head. Not a great fan of this texture for some reason. Reminds me a lot of Marathon. Not that that would be a bad thing, just looks old. Oh, what are you? Chloe? Ah, that's for a sword lever. It's weird that swords are exclusively used as levers in this game so far. Another Ankh. Bob's your uncle. And I assume up here is actually a door. So I should check out the sword lever first before I initiate some sort of encounter scenario. Gonna singe his eyebrows? That is not my intent whatsoever. We want the sword lever. Yay, I worked so hard. And I opened the door. Oh. Is there just another right in here? What's your freaking deal? I don't have another sword lever. Maybe I can craft them eventually. Oh! What? What did that do? Something on the other side of this door? Sounds like it. But I can't see anything. There's one here too. Maybe I've gotta weigh all of these down. There's one in every room? Yeah, there is. Alright, so I'm probably gonna have to come back here with another sword and then eventually figure out what to do with these doors and blocks. Or maybe I can take this sword back out. Oh, it swaps. Wait, try this. Get that all the way open. Pretty sure I could make it through. Let's leave our translocator disc out here. Because I'm a smart, smart man. Right, that's what we do. We'll hit this, immediately dash through the door. This will allow us through here. Well, I could have gotten through here anyway. And then we can hold down this and see what this does. No, we can flip this disc. I'm a disc flipper. Okay, okay. What is... Kerr's Chambers. The Sky Ones have begun their great work. I hear the cries of divine revelation. I have faith that we shall all benefit from their endless and deep wisdom. The dumb of the whiz. I do not feel like we've made any great revelations on this. Oh, did I light that? Okay, the light's on. Can I push this block? Cannot do anything with this block. They definitely have an on and off state. I get it. I think I just leave and see if we find a sword. Unless I was supposed to gather rubble from other rooms, like... What can I... Heavy! The shield is heavy, of course it is. So this is probably our solution right here, actually. So this means I can stand on two of them. But there's three.
Operator, tired. Sleep advised.
Oh no, I'm sleepy. It's like real life. Wait. Oh, that does actually push it down. Good. Where am I gonna sleep here? Sleep in the water trough out front. There's probably like one other type of object that I can hold. sleep, sleep. Negative 2 hours. Oh, that's like urgent, isn't it? Okay, is it safe to jump off of this? I hope this doesn't hurt. No, it looks kind of bad. Ah, that's too much. I just didn't want to go down the stairs. Is that really so bad? All right, fine. Jeez, I'll take the fast way. It doesn't break my face.
Operator, tired. Sleep advised.
All right, I'm gonna... Wait, does this say heavy? It does say heavy. So that's probably our solution right there. No, I just wanna... pick it up. Thank you. I guess just, like, take a crash on the floor. Here, get a full night. Break your ankle, helmet breaks, yeah. Sleeping around dead bodies, just a bad idea, IMO. It's not a terrible idea, to be honest. You're onto something with that one. Alright, so how many calzones do I have? 1,279 calzones. That's not very many calzones for my safety. But there were calzones on offer, right? Where was the food pot? The sludge? The food sludge? It was like one of these areas, wasn't it? Was it before this room? In here? Yeah, there it is. Mmm, so many cows.
Cal, I'm in one of these boxes. Find me.
Alright, we're good.
Reminder, your survival is of paramount importance.
I love that they still have to keep reminding me that living is important. I definitely get the idea. Okay, now we're good. Got a rock, which is heavy. I've got a shield here, which is heavy. Let's drop this sucker in here. Oop, over that. There we are. And then I'll stand on the... Oop, not the dev console, we're good. That is held down. Very nice, very nice. Hey, Aurences is here. Hello. Yeah, we exchanged emails. He's going to be giving away some codes for the game, which is awesome. And thank you very much for doing so. Oh, happy to find that sucker. I just freaking did not finish that puzzle. I'm going back. Don't worry. I just got distracted and went up instead of where I should have been. One key per scream. I don't really scream much, so unfortunately that's probably not gonna do the job. Not that I don't find the game ambience to be creepy. It certainly is. This didn't do what I was hoping it would do. Alright. Can I never get this sword back out? I don't think I can, right? I'm gonna have to figure out another way to get this sucker to work. So maybe I do have to go up after all. Oh, they even give me a rock and I didn't make that correlation. What is the matter with me? Might as well weigh them all down just in case that's useful. It's all open. Shields there. All lights are on. Oh, there's a fourth. The room to the left. How do I deal with you? What do I do here? To light that up. Is there... I mean, it wants me to do something with this Ankh, I guess. Oh, there's another shield. This shield, though, is not actually a shield, just looks like one. I don't see a weird wall at all. I'm confused. I don't see anything to do in here. Do I have an item, maybe, that I can do something with? Light crystal? Well, there was a light crystal before. Do you want the light crystal, Ankh?
No.
Ah, you're right, I forgot to set it to the proper game. Fixed. Well, that'll warm me up. I'm glad it's not freezing cold in this cave, at the very least. Maybe I'll shine light on the Ankh? Do you like that? Oh. That light's pretty nice, though. Oh, I like that, too. You can set your own stage lighting with it. Actually, just to check. I didn't know if that would just stay on while I wasn't in the room or wasn't using it. I mean, let's just keep walking up, I guess, and we'll see if there's something up there worth seeing. Oh, right, locked door. What about up here? Ah, the other sword, of course. Well, that would certainly make that a bit easier then. Nothing. Probably won't jump down that. I suppose that'll make sense once I put the other sword in. I thought I didn't notice that, but I realized, you know, that's how I opened the door. Having a really hard time navigating today. Alright. So this is not the same. I thought this was the same room as the one on the other side. I just have to... Okay, I just had to get them to click. Cool. Kerr's Chambers, one of two. I am Kerr of the Enlightened, anointed by the Utuku. I watched the Sky Ones descend countless moons ago. I am their ambassador. I will share their word of hope. Humans always have a word of hope, don't they? I'm gonna make Utaku great again. Ah, secrets. What's that? What's that? Max health plus 25. Never want to not have that. There's a lot of food in there, too. Non-perishable, of course. Alright, that brings us to a greater mystery, then. Does that open the door? Up here? Because if it doesn't, I don't know what does. Ah, maybe this. Easy. And forget your shield. I think I just needed it for the button. I don't think it's probably useful beyond that. Seems to be about as useful as a rock, so... Okay, we'll just, like, not touch those bear traps. No, I'm okay. I wonder if a lot of people have actually walked into those. They're pretty obvious. Maybe the problem is whatever's ahead is going to make me back into one. And whatever's ahead is, it's another one of those green sensor strips. Which I don't like. Oh no! Oh. I was like, well into it. What have I done? Give me light.
Dehydration.
Oh no! I should have paid more attention. Well, I'm at a save, so hopefully there'll be some liquids. Oh, hello. Scourge Warrior is up ahead. Kerr's Lament. Beware the Sky One's heinous invocation. It roams the halls, it hates life and fire. Oh, ancient gods of our old home. Reach across the cosmos and pluck us from our fate. I witnessed the work of the Sky One's chains, machines screaming, a window into moving darkness. It is for naught. Are we forsaken? Our offspring are next. I cannot stop them. Well, forward unto dawn. Gong. Hallways of Darkness 3. Everything is so neatly titled in this game.
Dehydration.
Yeah, no, I know about the dehydration. Maybe we'll see about sorting that out soon. I didn't fill my water bottle last time, so... Well, there goes that. How much do I have? 73. So that's probably enough to last me until I get to the next one. I certainly hope so, anyway. I just have to not take 500,000 years, because going back is not going to be convenient right now. What is this? I thought the door was moving for a split second. Oh, that was a camp. Of course I want to go that way. What am I... For some reason, I confused the camp indicator with the forward vector. Just trying to show me light and hope. I'll become less dehydrated. I wish I didn't drink that like 1 second ago, but now I can fill up the water bottles, it won't matter. I feel like it should keep your empty bottles equipped so you can fill them all up one after another. I don't need any more food. I think I've got enough. But I think it would just be reasonable, because then you could just go through right all of them and then be done. I guess I should sleep again, just since it's pretty much safe here and I can just drink again before I leave. I've got excessive amounts of food at this point. Those are... Yeah. I really should just not have that many with me. There's not a need to have that many cans when I've got those. Excuse me. I'm gonna sleep. Get a nice long night's sleep again. Not advised? Oh, what's... I didn't even look at the temperature. Oh, God. How about here?
Sleep not advised.
No? Too dangerous here? Not happy with it? No. Alright. Good. Now we've got more sleep than we could possibly need. This is a great place to sleep. Oh. Aaron says, I found a missing texture, guys. We gotta throw a texture on that. It's alright. No problem. Just wanted to show you. There it is. Okay. Failed. Too warm. Oh, it was lagged way behind the time that I was sleeping. Or trying to sleep. This is my specialty, by the way, finding missing textures. I do it semi-professionally. I'm not even really trying right now, though, but I probably would find a lot of them. Well, I'm not saying that you have missed a lot of them, but if there are many, I would probably find most of the ones that are missing. Ooh. Well, that's cool looking. What does that remind me of? Oh, it's like the things from Flow. Flameless Rite. So it's showing me that, a bunch of them were together, one lag behind, they all have their fire. It, like, picked off the last one? Did the fire go out? Oh, jeez. That can't be good. So those dudes on the left and right there have to be what we're walking away from, right? Those are the dudes that were standing up ahead of me. And there's my logo, kind of. So this is just like a thing they do, I guess. They have a group of people and they like send this thing out to eat one of them. And they just watch. It's not really funny, but apparently I'm laughing for some reason. Ooh, ooh, tiny little people in bowls, tiny little babies, that's never good. Yeah, this music's getting pretty intense. Babies in bowls, not a thing that I want to see. Preparing to exit Vault 111. Whoa, what? What's that all about? Be careful with fire. That... Oh, it's coming down the whole hallway, huh?